is Keke, aka Shyfacediva. Thanks for joining me in the kitchen again. The weather is so cold out here in Texas now. So what's a better meal to make today rather than beef stew or some type of stew? Okay, so I already got everything going here. So what have I already did? I already have been boiling my stew meat for over an hour, about an hour and 10 minutes. And I drained some of the water out towards the bottom. I'm about to add all of my stuff in now. Okay, this is about a pound and a half of beef stew. Once it's been boiled for about an hour, I'm going to be adding everything in it now. I'm going to add a can of mixed vegetables. A can of diced tomatoes. Make sure I get all that out. And a can of tomato sauce. I cut up 3 potatoes, add that in there. And I pre-cut up my onion, celery, and bell pepper. You can add as how much you want, depending on your taste. Okay. Now I'm gonna stir this up. Oh yeah, y'all, it's smelling awful shame. Next, I'm going to be adding 1/4 cup of flour in there, and this is gonna make it thicken up. You can also add cornstarch, because cornstarch is more of a finer feel to it, but I'm using flour. I'm not gonna add any seasoning to it until I have it thickened up like I want it to. Gonna be good. So I'm gonna let this boil for another 35 to 40 minutes and come back and check on it. So I'm gonna cover it back up and I'll be right back. Okay, you guys, so it's 35 minutes later and I love the consistency of it, so I'm not gonna add any more flour to it. It's very meaty, lots of vegetables in there. Now it's time to add the seasonings. I'm going to start off with, I know y'all know about Lawry's, put some Lawry's in there. And you know, you add seasoning, you add a little at a time to try to make sure, you know, you don't over season. The next thing I'm going to do is onion powder. Next part I'm going to use is garlic powder. And last is paprika. Now paprika is really good because it really gives it the color. It turns that stew meat that brownish, reddish looking color. Okay, after I add the seasoning, I'm just gonna mix it in. Okay. And I'm just gonna let this cook for about 30 more minutes on low so all the seasonings can marry each other. And that's basically it on how to do beef stew. There's really not a way not how to do it. You just gotta, you know, see what works best for you. But this is a pretty simple recipe. And yeah, I think I'm going to be serving this over white rice and with cornbread. But yeah, guys, until next time, I will see y'all later. And thanks for joining me.